Is garlic a friend or enemy? Garlic, scientifically known as Allium sativum, is not just a flavorful spice. It has a long history of being hailed as a remedy for a myriad of ailments and is renowned for its medicinal properties, serving as an antibiotic, antithrombotic, and anti-neoplastic agent. Its uses span thousands of years, encompassing culinary, medicinal, and even spiritual realms. The composition of garlic is quite complex, boasting at least 33 sulfur compounds, numerous enzymes, and 17 amino acids. Unique to garlic are steroidal glycosides and lectins. Among the Allium species, garlic stands out with the highest concentration of sulfur compounds, which not only contribute to its distinctive pungent odor, but also underpin many of its medicinal effects. Extensive research, with over 3,000 publications, has validated the efficacy of garlic in preventing and treating various diseases, thus affirming its traditional applications. While its influence on heart disease risk is acknowledged, garlic's role in addressing fatigue remains somewhat elusive. The anti-fatigue function of garlic is thought to be interconnected with its myriad favorable biological and pharmacological effects. Throughout history, garlic has been employed to alleviate an array of conditions, from aches and pains to leprosy, deafness, and digestive issues. It has been credited with the ability to lower blood pressure, treat food poisoning, combat tumors, and even act as a mild anticoagulant. Across different cultures, from Arabian herbalists treating abdominal pain to Ayurvedic medicine addressing respiratory problems, garlic has left its aromatic mark. In contemporary usage, garlic finds its place in addressing conditions related to the blood system and heart, including atherosclerosis, high cholesterol, heart attacks, coronary heart disease, and hypertension. Beyond cardiovascular health, some people turn to garlic for its potential preventive role against lung cancer, prostate cancer, breast cancer, stomach cancer, rectal cancer, and colon cancer. However, it is crucial to note that while many of these uses have historical and traditional roots, not all of them are substantiated by rigorous scientific research. A word of caution arises from a study published in the journal Food and Chemical Toxicology, which suggests that short-term heating diminishes the anti-inflammatory effects of fresh raw garlic extracts. This poses a potential challenge for individuals who find the taste or odor of fresh garlic off-putting. So, in the ongoing debate of garlic's virtues and vices, the answer lies somewhere in the nuanced intersection of tradition, scientific inquiry, and personal preference. Garlic and lung cancer risk. In a 7-year study in China, researchers at the Jiangsu Provincial Center for Disease Control and Prevention found that people who ate raw garlic at least twice a week had a 44% lower risk of developing lung cancer. The study involved face-to-face interviews with 1,424 lung cancer patients and 4,543 healthy individuals. Participants were questioned about their diet, lifestyle, smoking habits, and how often they consumed garlic. The researchers, whose findings were published in the journal Cancer Prevention Research, noted a protective association between raw garlic intake and lung cancer. They observed a dose-response pattern, suggesting that garlic might act as a preventative agent for lung cancer, garlic, and brain cancer. Garlic's organosulfur compounds have shown effectiveness in destroying cells in glioblastomas, a deadly type of brain tumor. Scientists at the Medical University of South Carolina reported in the journal Cancer that 3 specific organosulfur compounds in garlic, DAS, DADS, and DATS, dialyl sulfide, dialyl disulfide, and dialyl trisulfide, exhibited efficacy in eradicating brain cancer cells. Among them, DATs proved to be the most effective. Co-author Ray Swapen, PhD, highlighted the potential of plant-originated compounds, like those found in garlic, as natural medicine to control the malignant growth of human brain tumor cells. However, further studies in animal models are needed before applying these strategies to brain tumor patients. Garlin and hip osteoarthritis. A study by researchers from King's College London and the University of East Anglia in England revealed that women with diets rich in Allium vegetables, including garlic, had lower levels of hip osteoarthritis. Allium vegetables encompass garlic, leeks, shallots, onions, and reikiō. The long-term study involved over 1,000 healthy female twins. The findings not only emphasize the potential impact of diet on osteoarthritis outcomes, but also suggested the possibility of using compounds in garlic to develop treatments for the condition. Is garlic a potentially powerful antibiotic? Dialyl sulfide, a compound found in garlic, demonstrated remarkable effectiveness in fighting the Campylobacter bacterium, one of the leading causes of intestinal infections. According to a study published in the Journal of Antimicrobial Chemotherapy, this garlic compound was 100 times more effective than two commonly used antibiotics. Dr. Xiaonan Liu from Washington State University, the senior author of the study, expressed excitement about the potential of this compound to reduce disease-causing bacteria in both the environment and our food supply. Garlic and heart protection. Researchers at Emory University School of Medicine discovered that a component in garlic oil, known as dialyl trisulfide, plays a protective role for the heart during cardiac surgery and after a heart attack. They believe this compound could even be used to treat heart failure. While hydrogen sulfide gas has been identified as beneficial for the heart, it is challenging to use as a therapy due to its volatility. Hence, scientists turned their attention to dialyl trisulfide, a safer way to deliver the heart-protective benefits of hydrogen sulfide. Experiments with laboratory mice showed a 61% reduction in heart damage after a heart attack in those treated with dialyl sulfide compared to untreated mice. Additionally, a separate study in the Journal of Agricultural and Food Chemistry suggested that garlic oil might offer protection against cardiomyopathy, a leading cause of death in diabetes patients. Garlic and high cholesterol and high blood pressure. At Ankara University, scientists explored the impact of garlic extract supplements on the blood fat levels of individuals with high cholesterol. Published in the Journal of Nutritional Biochemistry, the study involved 23 volunteers, some of whom also had high blood pressure. After 4 months of taking garlic extract supplements, participants showed improvements in blood lipid levels, enhanced antioxidant potential, and significant reductions in both systolic and diastolic blood pressures. Although it was a small study, the researchers indicated the need for further investigations. Garlic and prostate cancer. A study conducted at the China-Japan Friendship Hospital in Beijing examined the relationship between allium vegetable consumption, especially garlic, and prostate cancer risk. Analyzing studies up to May 2013, the researchers reported in the Asian Pacific Journal of Cancer Prevention that allium vegetables, particularly garlic intake, were associated with a decreased risk of prostate cancer. They emphasized the necessity for additional well-designed studies to verify these findings. Garlic and alcohol-induced liver injury. Researchers at Shandong University in China explored the potential protective effects of dialyl disulfide, DADS, a garlic-derived compound against ethanol-induced liver injury caused by prolonged alcohol overconsumption. The study, published in Biochimica et Biophysica Acta, suggested that DADS might help safeguard the liver from the detrimental effects of excessive alcohol intake. Garlic and the risk of spontaneous preterm delivery. Microbial infections during pregnancy can heighten the risk of preterm delivery. Researchers at the Norwegian Institute of Public Health investigated the impact of food, specifically alliums like garlic, on antimicrobial infections and the risk of preterm delivery. Published in the Journal of Nutrition, the study involving nearly 19,000 women suggested that the intake of foods with antimicrobial and prebiotic compounds, particularly garlic, might lower the risk of spontaneous preterm delivery. However, further research, especially in diverse populations, is essential to solidify these findings. Garlic and the common cold. A study from St. Joseph Family Medicine Residency in Indiana, titled "Treatment of the Common Cold in Children and Adults," suggested that regularly using garlic might decrease the frequency of colds in adults. However, it did not seem to affect the duration of symptoms. Prophylactic use of garlic, meaning using it regularly to prevent illness, may offer some benefits against the common cold, according to this research. Although some studies indicate raw garlic may provide the most benefits, the overall intake of garlic, both raw and cooked, has been associated with positive effects, allowing for varied and enjoyable consumption to reap its advantages. As we conclude our exploration into the world of garlic, we hope you've gained valuable insights into its medicinal mysteries. Whether you view garlic as a trusted friend or remain cautious of its potential impact, the journey has been enlightening. Remember, this information is not a substitute for professional medical advice, so consult your healthcare provider for personalized guidance. If you enjoyed delving into the scientific nuances of garlic, give us a thumbs up, share your thoughts in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe for more intriguing insights into the fascinating realms of health and wellness. Until next time, stay curious and stay healthy.